Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a classic LEGO space set. This is the Xenon X-Craft. Came out in 1985 with 86 pieces. The color scheme makes it look like it was trying to remember the original classic space sets, right? Numbers, where were they? 918, 924, and 928 with the yellow canopy cover and the blue main color. It also has a feature that's very similar to those old sets. It's got the little cargo compartment in the back with the opening doors. It uses the 2-brick tall doors. It's got doors on both sides, so you can open that up completely. It's got enough room to put something small inside of there. Okay, good start so far. Let's see, these things on the front could be used as weapons, or they could be used as some sort of, you know, sensor of some sort. Big old engine on the back, some RCS thrusters on the sides, little flexible hose connecting up to there. And what else do we have going on here? We'll take a look at the little figures, if you will. This is an interesting thing here with the sides. These are supposed to be out like that. However, like some of the other mid-80s sets, this is completely open on the side, even though it's got a closed top. That's a little bit awkward to me that they want it to be like this. Well, it doesn't have to be like that. You can just close these up. There, problem solved. Now your sides are closed. Yeah, there's little gaps, but who cares? You don't have to be perfect about it. So that to me just feels more comfortable. I guess the wings end up not looking quite as substantial this way, but I feel like it has a little more texture and detail down the sides, and it's nice that it's actually covered. Just makes a little more sense that way. Inside of here, you will find a single printed tile piece, the blue version, less common than the gray, the light gray version of that same print, also available on light gray tiles. And that pretty much takes care of everything that you get from this main build. The yellow classic space guy with the second generation period appropriate helmet with the thicker chin strap is paired up with a good sized little robot companion. You could use the robots to pilot the ship, I think, kind of as an autopilot if you want. Use them as an astromech, or you could just use them on the ground as a little helper. And you can see he's got arms that, of course, you can pose, and he can also be leaned forward and back because the whole thing is on a hinge base. These antennae tend to get a little bit worn out. Lever pieces tend to get a little worn out over time. So if you breathe on that a little bit too hard, one of those ears will fall down. Both of these are looking in appropriate shape for their ages. Looks like they were taken care of respectably well. Still got the gold on the front of the spaceman, but he's got some scuffs and, you know, a little bit of stuff that's kind of embedded into it. So it's just perfect for the age. This did come with the original instruction sheet with the original print on the front, but unfortunately, this is one of those that does not include an alternate build in the instruction sheet. No worries. I also got a piece of the original box with this set when I purchased it. So if we look at the back, see how this goes, something like that. There's the side. If we look at the back, you can see some of the suggested alternate builds made with the parts from this set. I'll start from the top there. That's an interesting looking one. I wish that they had used the wing pieces, you know, the wedge plate pieces, maybe farther back just a little bit. Would have been a good use of more of the pieces, but still a pretty respectable looking thing. This is interesting here. It looks like they're opening up the back, just hinging it down, maybe to get in there and work on it, because it looks like he's grabbing for that right there, which is being used as a wrench, I think. It's kind of like when your spaceship breaks down, you know, you gotta work on it yourself wherever you crash land. This is a wild looking thing. Looks like I think this is some sort of survey device, and these front things are going up and down like feelers or antennae on some insect and insect-like animals. That's quite different. And then the last thing over here, well, that's good. That looks like it might be kind of the 1985 classic space version of a Reaper drone. Got the high aspect ratio wings there. It is armed and it's being piloted by a robot for your core intelligence, artificial intelligence, and a bunch of stuff put together in the back. Another pretty respectable looking and different build. Very cool. Another good little spacecraft for the classic space collection. Almost done with 1985. Maybe by the time you watch this video, I'll have all of the 85s and everything before then as well, but stay tuned for more to come. You'll also be seeing another update for my classic space layout when that becomes available. If you have any thoughts you would like to share about this set here though, please do down in the comments section. And like I said, stick around for more. More is on the way. Bye for now.